iOS 18 is finally here. Some of the features are really good while some are just nostalgic. Let's see how much of iOS 18 is actually Android. Let's get started. First of all, iOS 18 takes customization to a whole new level. This will be the first time ever that you'll be able to move apps within the home screen. You can place the apps and widgets anywhere you like, and not just that, you can even resize them. It's cool if you're an iPhone user, and if you're watching this on Android, this wouldn't come across as a feature, but nevertheless, it's good to have. Apart from that, you can also change the colors of the icons in a lot of different ways. There's this tinted one that looks, well, different, and there's this monochrome one that is actually not bad. And with the slider, you can adjust the colors and change the size easily. Now, I'm not sure if I like this, but you know where this is from, right? Let me know in the comments. In customization, Apple definitely took a lot of inspiration from Android. But now, let's talk about the updated control center. Because most Android screens, quick settings will probably look like this. So pay attention, guys. The icons are now circular and looks refreshing if you compare it with iOS 17. There's even a power toggle up here. The network menu has more options now, and you can easily swipe through multiple pages. The best part is that you can completely change it to your likings. You can add new toggles, adjust size, and even add as many pages as you want and cycle through them like this. By the way, you can replace your lock screen widgets with other toggles so that you never get called out for having your flashlight turned on by accident. Let's talk about the features now. You can now natively lock any of the apps easily by just long pressing the app and tapping this. This is quite useful, as not all the apps offer app locking feature. Apart from that, you can also hide apps easily and they'll disappear from the home screen and even spotlight. You'll find them in this hidden apps folder, which only you can access. Now, some Android skins do come with these features, but this one last thing is something new. It's the limited contact access feature, which limits the app from seeing all your contacts, as you can restrict it to certain contacts. It's quite similar to limited access in media files that we have seen in both iOS and Android. Now, one feature that none of us expected from Apple was the native call recording option. Yes, you can now record calls directly from the phone app and can also get a text summary of the same. But do note that this will notify the other person that the call is being recorded. It's not live yet, but I'm sure a lot of users will appreciate this feature. And yeah, the phone app finally supports T9 search as well. Not sure why Apple took so many years for this, but I'm glad it's available now. Now, there's something for the gamers as well. iPhones have finally gotten a game mode, which will reduce background tasks to improve the gaming experience and will also reduce latency with AirPods Gen 2. Now, as of yet, the game mode is quite basic compared to what we get on Android, and we didn't see any noticeable difference in latency, but it's good to see that Apple is doing something for the gamers. I really hope the game mode evolves and become more useful. And yeah, your favorite offline app also got a major redesign. Yes, you guessed it, I'm talking about the Photos app. The Photos app is redesigned to make it more organized. It's unified with recent photos at the top and collections at the bottom. Swipe down to see the recent photos, and you can even filter out screenshots. And swipe up to see collections which are categorized by dates, people, and memories. You can also pin some collections that you access more often. I really like this new unified design, but I wish it had a feature like Google Throwback Photo Stories, which adds a surprise element that brings back memories and photos you have long forgotten. Apart from that, the Messages app also got some new handy features. You can now schedule the messages, which is great if you forget birthdays or your own anniversary. You can now format text and even add these cool looking text effects. And if you hate typing, you can just choose any emoji to react, which wasn't the case earlier. Apple also showed RCS messaging, but it's not live yet. The Notes app also got smarter, as it can now transcribe audio notes and can even do calculations for you. Just look at this. Isn't it crazy? Lastly, if you have music playing on your phone and you open your camera app to record a video, the music will not stop. This is again quite useful. And since it's Apple, the attention to detail in some places is mind-blowing. There's this button press animation that just looks sick. And you can now control the width of the flashlight as well. And oh, I almost forgot. Apple is also bringing artificial intelligence. I mean, Apple intelligence to its users. Now, it's not live yet, but it'll be available only for the iPhone 15 Pro series and onwards. Now, you must be wondering, why not on iPhone 14 or 13? Well, this is because the 3 billion parameter SLM runs locally, and local models require a lot of RAM to work, hence the limitation. So what does it do? Basically, it can help you write, format, proofread texts across apps, can generate images for you, and can take actions based on natural language. You will be able to do all the AI tasks on your iPhone itself, and will also be able to interact with your iPhone with just the prompts, and won't have to fiddle with endless settings and toggles. This will definitely make Siri a lot more useful than it is right now. So that was it from my side. Like we expected, iOS 18 is a very good update, although a lot of it is taken from Android and a lot of it is still coming soon, but nevertheless, it's still a very good update. And both Android and iOS are mature enough to copy each other's goodness from time to time. Now, which iOS feature that you want Android to copy? Tell us in comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.